Wednesday the 4th, Thursday the 5th, I'm seeing you hoard your money. And the money looks good. It almost reminded me of the Christmas guy, Ebenezer Scrooge. And people were coming around, they were like, can I have a piece of coal? And he was like, no. And then they were like, you know, can I get a turkey or have off? And they were like, no. So I get the impression that you might be hoarding. And it didn't look literal as much as it was a mental state where you're kind of examining, oh, thank God, you know, I'm finally in a secure place financially. Doesn't feel nice to sit in my beautiful house on my lovely sofa, you know, with my cat. Maybe, you know, the kids needed something and you were like, wasn't it nice to just be able to not have to look at the price tag and go get that for them or whatever it is. And you're understanding that that level of comfort isn't going to be pulled from your grasp very easily. So I think that you finally reach this you know, platform here and you don't want to come down off of it, but there is some like investment opportunity coming up later here in the week. And if you don't spend it, you can't make more. Okay. So you have to put your money where your mouth is. And you have shown that you can take what you have and use it as leverage. You have shown that you can work from the bottom up and build things. You've shown that you can use your smarts to be successful and your communication skills to be successful. There's no reason you can't do this too. I think you're going to have to look back and I think you're going to have to say, look, I've done it before, okay? And I could do it again. And it's no time to buckle, okay? So Friday the 6th, there's talk of investment. There's also talk about a lover coming to you on Saturday the 7th. So when I say lover, I mean, I'm just talking, you know, this could be your wife, your husband, your someone you're dating, whatever it is. Someone you're pretty serious about, though, seems to want to go somewhere. And they want to do this with you. It feels romantic. And I saw a tropical place. That can mean a vacation, obviously. But it can also just mean, you know, going away together, maybe spending some time, and it could cost a bit. And I feel like even there, Ebenezer Scrooge again. I don't need to do this. This isn't the right time. You know, we just went over here, you know, and I have this person saying, yeah, but that wasn't real. Maybe the kids were there, or, you know, it wasn't designed for it to be just about us. You know, that was a work trip or whatever. You need to be willing to wiggle a bit. And I think in that particular situation, you have to look at it as though this is something that your lover wants or needs from you. And it has more to do with your time and attention and affection, although you're probably going to have to throw some money at the problem. But I think that you need to give it, okay? Sunday the 8th. I was seeing some people around you kind of letting you down. And then I saw on Monday the 9th some talk of an investment potentially being slowed down due to some people not doing everything that they need to. So I want to say that on both of those days, whether this be romantic, this be personal, be family, be work related, pay attention for situations or people that are not stepping up and doing everything that they need to, and in what areas it could be slowing you down. If you can catch things like this before they come to a head, it's either preventative or you can go with like disciplinary action or boundary setting, and you can fix it before it becomes a thing, okay?